dog revolt and dominate. They are then no more attracted to their original center but seek another. Atomic sphere, if I might so express it, dissipates.
Consciously and definitely to bring about.
about individualization. That it is not done and yet is due to the danger of imparting the necessary knowledge. The adepts understand the transmuting process in the three worlds and in the four kingdoms of nature, which make them a temporary esoteric free and exoteric core. And will eventually work with the three kingdoms, but only when brotherhood is a practice and not a light from one stage of atomic existence to another, and it involves three distinct steps, which can be seen and traced by means of the higher clairvoyance and from the higher plane. These steps or stages are 484 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. The fiery states of blending, fusing, burning period, through which all atoms pass during the disintegration of form. The solvent stage, in which the form is dissipated as substance is held in solution, the atom being resolved into its essential duality. The volatile stage, which concerns primarily the essential quality of the atom, and the escape of this essence as later to take a new form. Radioactivity, related solution, and essential volatility might express the thought. In every transmuting process without exception these three steps are followed. Occultly expressed in the old commentary they are thus stated. Fiery lips burn within the bosom of Mother. The fiery center extends to the periphery of the circle of dissipation supervenes in Pelaic peaks. The sun returns to the bosom of Father, and Mother rests quiescent. Masters, in concert with the great Devas, concern themselves with this transmutation process, and each department might be considered as dealing with one of the three stages. The Mahachohan's department in its five divisions deals with the burning of the fiery lives. The Manu's department concerns itself with the form or the ring path knot which encloses the burning of the lives. The Radhasattva's department deals with the return of the sun to the bosom of the Father. Of the Mahachohan, a secondary division along these lines might be outlined. The seventh and fifth rays are occupied with the return of the sun to the Father and are largely centered in pouring forth energizing power when it becomes necessary to transfer the life of the sun from an old form into a new, from one kingdom of nature to another on the path of return. THEFACTOROFMANAS 485. The third and sixth rays dealing with burning of the fiery lives. The fourth blends the two fires within the atomic form. It will be seen from a close study of these subdivisions how close is the cooperation between the different groups and how interrelated are their activities. The work of the hierarchy can be interpreted always in terms of alchemy, and their activities deal with a threefold transmutation. This work is carried on by them, consciously, and supervenes upon their own emancipation. A master transmutes in the three worlds and principally concerns himself with the process upon the 18 subplanes, the great field of human evolution, and with the passage of their life throughout the dense physical body of the Logos. The Chohans of the sixth initiation work in the fourth and fifth Eastern Kingdom Logos. Etheric body, Vedic and Atmic planes, and deal with the passage of the life of spirit from form to form in those realms, having in view the transmutation of Venus in the spiritual kingdom into the monadic. Those on still higher levels, the Buddhas and their confreres of the first and third rays, deal with the passage of the life into the subatomic and atomic planes of the cosmic city. What has been said applies to all hierarchical efforts in all schemes and on all globes, for the unity of effort is universal. In every case, conscious self-induced control or authority receives ability to transmute. Initiates learn to transmute and superintend the passage of the life out of the animal kingdom into the human after the herd initiation, and during the earlier stages of initiation, and formulas that control the lesser devas, and which produce results in the merging of the second and third kingdoms were communicated as they work under safeguards and supervision. Advanced intellectual man should be able to cooperate in the sense LS of the work and deal with the trans 486 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Mutation of the metals as the ratio of their intellectual development to that of the mineral elements and builders finding with control. The same as in the above-mentioned cases and grades of consciousness, owing to the disastrous development in Atlantean days, and the consequent stultification of spiritual evolution for us. Time until karma has been adjusted, heart has been lost, or rather, the knowledge has been safeguarded until a period is reached in the racial progress wherein the physical body is pure enough to withstand the forces contacted and to emerge from the process of chemical transmutation enriched, not only in knowledge and experience, but strengthened in its own inner fiber. As time proceeds, man will gradually do four things. 1, 2, 3. Recover past knowledge and powers developed in Atlantean days. Produce bodies resistant to the fire elemental and the lower kind which work in the mineral kingdom. Comprehend the inner meaning of radioactivity, for the settings will see the power inherent in all elements and all atoms of chemistry, and in all true minerals. 4. Reduce the formulas of the coming chemists and scientists now, and not simply formulate through experiment on paper. In this last statement lies, for those who can perceive, the most illuminating hint that it has been possible to yet impart on this matter. It may seem that I have not communicated much information amid this conscious manipulation of the fire. That lies in the inability of the student to read the esoteric background of the above communicated statements. Conscious transmutation is possible only when a man has transmuted the elements in his own vehicles. Then only can he be trusted with the secrets of divine alchemy. PHEFACTOROFMANAS 487. With through the latent internal fires of the matter of his own sheets, he has transmuted the chemical and mineral atoms in those sheets. Then can he safely through affinity of substance A to work with mineral transmutation of the first order. Only when through the radiatory fires of the sheets he has transmuted the correspondence to the vegetable kingdom within his own organism, alchemically the work of the second order. Only when the fires of mind in himself dominate, can he work with the transmutative processes of the third order, or with the transference of life into the animal form. Only when the self within, or the ego in the cosmic body, is in control of his sprinkled personality, totally be permitted to be an alchemist of the fourth order, and work in connection with the transmutation of the animal monad into the human kingdom, with all the vast knowledge that is included in that idea. Much lies ahead to be accomplished, but in the appreciation of the magnitude of the task need be no place for discouragement, for the wise outlining of the future in the cautious promulgation of knowledge concerning the necessitated stages will come strenuous effort and aim on the part of many aspirants, and the evolutionary bringing in of those who can achieve. down certain postulates which must be carefully borne in mind when considering this question of transmutation. They are five in number and concern specifically matters wherein the transmuting process is carried on. Recollect at this juncture the distinction that is made between the work of the black and the white magician. It might be helpful here before proceeding further to look at these distinctions as far as they concern the matter in their